Perfect.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Reaction Therapy. I am Tom Stevens, your resident psychotherapist, here to break down lyrics for Patreon subscribers only. Today's reaction goes out to Zachary Zabala, one of our very few in the select few tier of our subscription. Thank you, Zachary, so much for, number one, your patronage, number two, investing your time and money into Reaction Therapy, and number three, for giving everybody at Reaction Therapy here on Patreon a chance to hear some really cool music. And Zachary has picked for his choice, one free request each month, he has picked NF and Dreams. So today we are breaking down Dreams by NF. And this is awesome because number one, it's not on the journey. And number two, it's another NF song I have no idea about that I get a chance to hear. I'm guessing it's about his dreams to aspire, to become something, to become somebody. And it meant enough to Zachary that he wanted everybody to hear it. So Zachary, thank you. And don't forget, that's one of the perks of being at the top two levels of Reaction Therapy on Patreon, is you get a chance every month to have one free request. You pick it, we react to it, everybody gets it, and it's a really cool thing. So Zachary, this one's for you. Without further ado, let's get into NF and Dreams. Man.
Full of sad days, started at a young age, yeah. Bought a house, but I've been living on stage, trying to find a real me. I ain't found it yet. Wake up every morning feeling like I'm guilty.
Such good NF. I mean, I did not expect this, but this, I don't even know when this was written, how it fits into wherever he was in his career. Very clean, crisp words. The beat is phenomenal, just how hard that is, and just steady. And I love the line that I hear about him buying a house, but living his life on stage. Like he's got a house he's been able to buy and afford, but he can't even be in it because he's out on stage and touring and do all kinds of things. And I feel like he's just kind of going to talk about being lost at this point. And I don't know where I'm at, you know, achieve dreams. And it's not really what I thought it would be, but what a beginning. Zachary, banger. Here we go.
Yeah. Most of my life's full of sad days. Started at a young age. Yeah. Bought a house, but I've been living on stage. Trying to find a real me. I ain't found it yet. Wake up every morning feeling like I'm guilty. Talk to God, can you hear me? Lately, I'm a mess. I don't want no one to help me.
Yeah.
I don't want no one to help me. And if you think that I make decisions based off of what you think, then you're wrong. Can't nobody think for me, I got my own thoughts. Sometimes you don't know what you had until it's all gone. Till it's all gone. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere in life.
He's telling everybody, look, what you're telling me and what you think of me. Remember the thing I learned early on in my adulthood. Well, later in my adulthood, I should say, early on in my marriage and parenting days, was what other people think about you is none of your business, Tom. And I feel like he's saying that here. Like, what you're saying to me isn't affecting me. I'm hard enough on myself here. And, you know, reaching out to God saying, you know, help here a little bit. But this line of, if I took the hand that was dealt to me, I'd be nowhere. Because he had just horrible upbringing, you know, abusive, neglectful, not good examples, had to just kind of find his own way and had everything going against him. So if he took that hand, he wasn't dealt the great hand where he had everything, was given everything and just could rise to fame and stardom. He was given the hand of like, you're pretty much going to be in the gutter. You're not going to make it. You're nothing. You won't be anything. So just give up your dreams now because you have no chance. Like, even if you were in a better place growing up, you would have a better chance, but you've got no chance, NF. And he just would have nothing to do with it. And I think he learned how to make decisions that helped him get from one step to the next step to the next step, level up, and just keep growing and getting stronger. Oh, man. His thoughts that just rule him sometimes.
Till it's all gone. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere in life. Yeah, I had to think smart. Threw away the deck and got my own cards. Yeah. Long before I had the money to afford a car. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Following my dreams. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. I've been doing me.
Following his dreams. He's going after what he wants. I love that in people. Whether you ever attain your dreams or not isn't the goal, but if all you do is know you're not going to attain them, you'll never achieve them anyway, and you'll never even try to get to them. So you have to have those dreams. You have to dream big. You have to look at what you want to do. And like me, when I say I want to interview NF, I want to get in front of him, that's possibly never going to happen. I don't let that into my field of vision. I see it happening. I picture it happening. I pretend it. I imagine questions I'm going to ask, things I'm going to talk about, because that's how dreams come true. But I also have to become that person who's ready to do that. And so he's talking about dreams. And look, regardless of the music you like or don't like, because I love NF and I love this song. And some people will be like, that's trash. That's no good. This isn't good. Or that song's good. That song's not. And I hear that all the time from people. This song's terrible of that artist. This song's amazing. For me, since I don't know him as well, I feel like I'm listening to find something. And I get a lot of people who seem to listen to music to break something down or to tear something down instead of finding something in it that's gold, you know? And so for me, I hear this. I'm like, man, I'm hearing these words and they ring true to me. Like, I just need to do me. I need to live my life. I need to be the best that I can. Best advice for you, one foot in front of the other and try to do the best you can to be the best person, the best husband, the best father, the best friend, the best worker, the best child of God, the best whoever you need to be in life to somebody else and for yourself. And everything else starts to take care of itself. But you've got to have those dreams. You've got to know, where do you want to be a year from now, 3 years from now, 5 years from now? And let's work at what it's going to take to get there. And that's what happens inside my office.
Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me.
Yeah.
I've been doing me.
Yeah.
Following my dreams. Yeah, I've been doing me. Most of my life's full of regrets. Mm. Things I want to take back. Yeah. Wrote you a letter. Wish that I had never sent that. Didn't even make sense. I don't even know. All I know is I get lower on the weekends. Mm. They tell me I should make friends, I just sit at home. Lately I've been off the deep end, yeah. I've been off the deep end. If you think that I'm about to change who I am just for you, then you're so wrong. As a kid I built a house around my broke car.
He really describes things well, like vividly, like a story of, you know, if what other people think, what he thinks, and he gives you his thoughts inside. But listen to how he goes. The way he does the cadence in the song is so different than other NF songs. It's like he's semi-singing and semi-talking these verses, which is pretty cool.
The deep end. If you think that I'm about to change who I am just for you, then you're so wrong. As a kid, I built a house around my broke car. Sometimes you don't know what you had until it falls apart, till it falls apart. If I took the hand that was dealt me, then I would be nowhere in life.
Yep.
Yeah, I had to think smart. Threw away the deck and got my own cards. Long before I had the money to afford a car. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Following my dream.
Just doing him. He's doing him, which means he's doing the best he can with what he has. He is telling everybody, I started with nothing. Put it all on the table, just risking everything I've got, vulnerability, honesty, open, putting it all out there to be hit and attacked with. But I'm okay. I'm just doing me.
Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Following my dreams.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been doing me. I've been doing me. I've been doing me. Yeah, I've been doing me. Following my dreams. Yeah, I'm just doing me. Yeah, I'm just doing me. I'm reminiscing back to both of us laughing, playing old records, thinking every one of them's classic. Windows down, we on the street.
Who's he talking about here? Like a friend of his? Is it a relationship? Somebody that he's talking about back in the old day, I guess, when he was growing up or in high school and just dreaming about what he could be, you know, what he could do, who he could be. And windows down, just driving around in Michigan. Oh, man, this is pretty cool.
In my dreams. Yeah, I'm just doing me. Yeah, I'm just doing me. I'm reminiscing back to both of us laughing, playing old records, thinking every one of them's classic. Windows down, we on the street, up in Michigan rapping. We talked about it, but never really knew it could happen. My confidence about as low as the gases. We didn't have the money for it, so we turned the key backwards and sit in parking lots for hours to the...
Turn the key backwards. Do younger people in today's world even know what turning the key backwards? I feel like there's certain phrases I might know something about that younger people don't know about. You know, when you're turning the key backwards on your car, which really doesn't happen much anymore because so many cars have either push button starts or something. In the old days, you would turn the key backwards. Instead of turning it to the right to start a car, you would turn it all the way to the left. And that would allow the radio to play while you're sitting in your car without running the engine. And he's referencing turning the key backwards. I love this. And then, of course, it would run your battery, which if you played long enough would run your battery down. Then you try to start the car, it wouldn't start. And you'd need somebody to come along and jump your car for you, your battery. So this just makes me laugh because it takes me back to my days of growing up. And I've had batteries run out like that before. But he's with somebody just reminiscing, thinking about all the things that could happen. Never imagined anything happening. And here he is. I mean, his confidence is as low as the gas is. Like, well, I don't have money. All I got is this car I'm driving in with a little bit of gas in it. We're listening to music, thinking we're just dreaming. We're drifting off into dreamland, thinking of what could come.
In Michigan rapping, we talked about it, but never really knew it could happen. My confidence about as low as the gas is. We didn't have the money for it, so we turned the key backwards and sit in parking lots for hours till the battery crashes. I think that we related because both of us were looking for answers. A couple months ago, I drove in the Glab and got me all of my feelings. There's something about being somewhere that's familiar. Pulling the gas station, open up the tank, then I fill it, then laugh. Would I move back? Not in a million, but I appreciate the memories we had. I know you've been calling, sorry.
Somebody that's been call. I wonder what that is. Is that an actual person like that's calling? He's never called back. Like, he just kind of let the past be in the past. But he wouldn't. I mean, memories from Gladwin, memories from growing up, and he wouldn't trade them for the world. But he's not about to move back to that. Like, he's moved forward from that. He doesn't want to be back in that old cage, which was real hard.
Not in a million, but I appreciate the memories we had. I know you've been calling, sorry I never called back. I know I've been distant, you know I never meant that. You can tell the family how I'm doing if they ask. I'm just doing me.
I'd love to hear y'all's thoughts on who in the world is this about, what it's about, because that's a relationship type thing there. And dream. What a great, oh my goodness, what a great song. I just loved it. This is such a great addition. It's not even a part of the NF journey. Zachary Zabala, you hit it out of the park with this one. Great request out of nowhere. Might never have gotten requested, but to me, helps me appreciate NF that much more, especially when he takes us back to his roots. And Patreon subscribers, this shows you how valuable Patreon is, because this isn't something that's heading over to YouTube. This is something that's just for you, because somebody at the select few tier decided to make this request happen so everybody could hear it. And so cool. NF fans, Reaction Therapy fans, Reaction Therapy Patreon subscribers, here you go. This is it. Remember, this isn't real therapy. This is just Tom breaking down lyrics to music, having a blast doing it. But if you want real help, go to the link in our bio. Check it out. It has resources there. You deserve the help. Everybody does. And don't forget to follow us on Discord, or at least go into the Discord room. You don't have to follow us on Discord. We're just having a blast. Nick and I are loving this Patreon. Thank you so much for subscribing, for being a part of our family, and for keeping the magic happening, keeping our dreams happening. So thankful. And I can't wait to see you on the next Reaction Therapy.